All right, in this episode, I'm going to show you how I repair the center body of this RCA 77 series microphone. The Bakelite bodies chip and break easy. So stay tuned, I'm going to show you how I fix that. All right, looks like I got a box of parts in here I'm going to fix up for a customer. It consists of a lot of bodies, like this and this, and most of the time these bodies are broken, like all these. So they're supposed to look like this. They kind of look like this. Got a big chunk taken out of this ring right here. These are supposed to be all one piece, except for the holes. But it's a solid piece of Bakelite, and when you get chipped across there where the windscreen's made up to it, there was a fix. I'm not sure who started this, whether Clarence did. This one's been repaired. So from a distance back here, you know, you can't tell it's been repaired, but you look close, you know, inside here, you can still see that it's chipped. Even with the windscreens on, you can look down the top, tell it's been repaired. So, you know, you buy something on eBay and they show you a distant shot, looks good. You get it in, it's got a broken body. Here's what they look like before paint. Someone solders in this particular instance, it's a brass band across the top, and then they paint it to match, or paint the whole body to match it. It's fine and good, but I've got a better method. I'm going to show you how to fix it, or how I fix it. I wouldn't try this at home unless you have the proper tools like I do. All right, so I cut it down just about the thickness of the paint. A little bit less, actually, because I'm going to strip the paint off of this when I'm done. I take it down just where the center band makes the connection. And then I take I got hollow Delrin instead of wasting a solid chunk like I normally build the mic bodies with. It's got me a hollow piece, so I'm going to turn it down a ring just to slide over top of it. I missed putting it on. I slid it on with you heat up the band, cool this, and it slides on. You don't even need glue. I was going to get it back off again to show you how I put it together, but it's on there so tight I can't get it off. So you don't even need glue. You could put some on if you want, but it's such a tight fit, I doubt there's any room for the glue. Now this is fixed. You don't even see the seam. It just looks completely seamless. Where it joins in here, there's a little bit of scraping. I got to bead blast all this to clean it up, but you can't even tell a seam is there. Even if you did see a seam, it'd be covered by the center band. But it's virtually flawless. I'm going to bead blast it and show you how it looks completely. I'll tape it off again when I go to paint it. This gets the surface rough enough for paint to stick, because Delrin machines out super smooth. But there it is, complete seamless repair for the Labyrinth body. There it is, the finished product. All right, and here it is with the center band installed. It turned out really well. These are undetectable from any breakage, actually a little stronger than the original was. So if you want this service performed on your microphone, contact me through my website at www.bigdmc.com. Don't try to ask questions on my YouTube channel, as I usually don't have time to answer it. It's kind of a pain in the butt to answer questions on YouTube. So contact me through my website at, like I say, www.bigdmc.com. Perform this usually. Cost around $150 if you send your microphone in for me to fix the chip at the top. If you also, I sell the complete bodies made from scratch. If you'd want one of those, they're more expensive than doing this top part. And anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll have more videos like this coming up in the near future.